From what I've read on Reddit, today is Progressbar's birthday, and hold on. Okay, I'm back. So, today is Progressbar95's 2-year birthday. Congratulations, Progressbar95, on turning 2 years old. And to celebrate their birthday, Progressbar had released a little graph of all the features that were included since the very first public release of version 0.2.1. It had only one language, had only one system, which was Progressbar95, and only one game mode, which was the normal game mode. Pretty short and pretty simple. But with years of expansions and years of, well, adding up everything in between, I thought I'd give a special birthday episode as congratulations. For that, I just want to give a little message. Hold on. Okay, done. First of all, happy birthday, Progressbar95. You have given many hours of enjoyment in true to your tagline, you've made us smile. That is what I would expect in Progressbar95. But that's not the only thing I will be giving to Progressbar95 tonight. No, I'm going to give Progressbar95 its very own special episode. It would be called a Progressbar cookie, but I'm going to be calling it what it was originally called before Progressbar cookies was even conceived. Progressbar special. Yes, folks. This is going to be a very special episode of Progressbar95. So stay tuned for a whole bunch of laughs, a whole bunch of smiles, and a whole bunch of fun. Okay, gonna do the usual double check to make sure everything works. My Steam overlay came up. Oh, there we go, it worked. Works. Okay, you have the Progressbar computer site. 138 is this code. Alright. First journey into Progressbar. Let's look at some old operating systems that I had unlocked over the years. Pull that out of these. Oh, that's pretty good. This was a very Progressbar95 was the very first system, and also the only system in the Progressbar lineup in version 2.0. I hope they release that to the public soon. We're going to play a few more rounds of that. There's a cheat.txt file, been sleeping, thankfully, very peacefully, so we don't want to wake him up. Right. It's coming pretty good. Smoke alarm was pinging like crazy in the early morning. Sometimes in the late mornings. We'll move this closer to the bin, so I'll have access to delete it. Go. Come on, really? On top of that, we got a trash.txt file that just spawned. And I hear that Progressbar95 is putting in a task manager too for the June update. So you have to click keys control, alt, and delete. On top of this being Progressbar95's birthday episode, I'm also going to take a look back at some older episodes of Progressbar95, particularly my very first episode of Progressbar95. Progressbar95's birthday, but I'm giving you the gifts. Nice. Got a perfect score, that's pretty good. Okay. Nice. Check the settings in. Still don't have more accessibility features just yet. Check out this new cursor I got, though. I forgot the neon cursor even existed for this one. No need to defrag my system just yet. And I mean the system in, and I of course mean the system in game. Ooh, 95%. Almost there, almost there. Alright! Let's do those Progressbar95, the very first Progressbar95 system. Up next, Progressbar95 Plus. Oh. Here we have Progressbar95 Plus. It appeared from the, I think the second video on, my second video Progressbar95 online. And the first became the second difficulty, relaxing. Okay, got 15% already. This is actually a pretty cool trip down memory lane for me. game. For those of you who may never played Progressbar95, it's a pretty good history lesson into the progress made of Progressbar95.
You've got mail.
You know, starting with the mailbox update, Progressbar95 Plus was the first system to get mailbox communication. It's available starting with Progressbar95 Plus up onward, and for Bar OS starting with Bar OS 9 and onward. As for the media player, it's been available starting from Progressbar95 Plus or the media. Was it already available in the game? I'm not sure. Right. If we're going up from the GUI based systems, Progressbar98. Now this is a system I usually end up on in my videos. Well, depending on the for the most part, that is. Sometimes I in videos on earlier systems or later systems. Look at that. Screensaver mode. Really fantastic, and there we go, 80%, 85%, 90%. We're getting there. All right. Needless to say, I got an expert on this system. Now, the Progressbar9X systems, particularly 95 to, I think, ME, did not originally come with Progress Commander installed on them. It was a later update that offered this. Not sure which one it was, though. Hey. That is perfect. All right. Progress bar in E. This is, of course, based on the operating system that got rushed in time for the new millennium. There's a little matrix screen saver there too, so. That's pretty cool. Anyway. All right, that's a pretty perfect score, I guess. And I noticed that the section is green in the matrix screen saver. Okay. Didn't know why those bricks were there. Progress bar 95 has not been most of the time at any rate. Now some of the examples of progress bar you rarely see are the video driver. Which for the most part the video driver seems to work pretty good. Okay. Okay, so then we just got the question there. It'd be nice if they had released the birthday update where on Progress Bar's birthday, we get to play special mini games. Those are pretty cool. I mean, those would be pretty cool. Oh. See, this is what I mean by this rarely occurring. This is gonna be disadvantageous for colorblind people. Thankfully, the problem fixed itself before I had to consider restarting. Okay. So. Last one, let's do a hardcore. It's 55% right now. Okay, that's good. Oh, the laser pop-up. This is one of those pop-ups I hate. Being... Oh, shit! Well, at least game progress works, so... Yeah, I had to click it. Kind of annoying. Are you kidding me? A yellow progress bar in the middle of all that? That was pretty good, but not perfect. Before I forget, I'll show you the predecessor. After, of course, showing you the Loop 2000. Okay. Already doing good. That's 40%. This clippy again.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
Now the bin nightmare, I still can't come to grips with it. Now with the progress bar system, we need a new e-operation one. You get sort of an unmissable, cannot ignore notification. Like literally, you can't ignore it when it comes up. You have to click on it. Alright. Let's restart. And just like I promised, I'll show you the process. Our first predecessor is PB DOS Shell. Okay, here we go. You used to be able to hold the button for more points on the PC version. Now I don't think you can. I like the fact that in the PC version of PB DOS Shell, you have to sort of key to press to use the action, to choose, use the action. Although, it's kind of weird how it's always assigned to a random key. Be nice if they chose one specific key and did not deviate from that key at all. Make more sense, wouldn't it? Okay. This system was voted the worst system in the Progress Bar, well, for some reason. And I can see where some of the complaints come from. Progress Bar moves real slow when you're moving it around the screen. That was the perfect score! And Progress Bar saw shit. And here's the main reason I use PBDOS shell. PBDOS itself. Let's see what I have. Okay. The main reason why I use PBDOS shell. Sometimes you'll need to access README files. Okay, we need a text codes. So let's see what we have here. In the directory, I see. Jesus, somewhat unprofessional typing. hello world. I will see you learn how to code. Here we are. And there we go. Okay, more hex code. Let's see what we have. GPM. Yeah. Take a photo of this real quick. Let's see. Okay, with that, I'm going to go ahead and have some lunch. I'll be right back. Well, hey there. Okay. Now, where was that? Where was that? No, Progressbar 10 entitled My Dog. That should be correct. Okay, so let's see what we have here. Okay, so more hex code. Let's see what we have. Okay. 36 might be the trick. And it did. Thank you. Okay. There was no point in entering that directory, was there? I'm gonna restart. And here's progress bar 1. You guys liking the old school layout? Alright, perfect score! Quite a bit of perfection, I must say. Want to know which other version of Progress Bar I used or Progress DOS? And no, it's not version 2, though I will show that before I show 3.14, but 3.14. It's 50%. Pretty good. 85%, doing good. Thank you. Oh no! Shit! There we go. If the air is cleared out, we can focus on getting the last segment we need. There, that's perfect. Don't worry, I'm eventually going to get an expert on this one. It just might take a while. Let's restart. Okay, this is an unexpected surprise. Progressbar not 3.0. Thought I'd show off a little bit of custom gameplay before we get into Progressbar 3.1. Oh, and it even has the program manager. I see you, yellow thing. You can't be doing this to me. Shit. Really? About 30%, 35%. Yeah, hello, Quibi. Go to running DLL again. There we go. Thank you. You have two systems for custom gameplay. So right now, let's focus on 8.14 Pro. And here is progress points. Alright, perfect score. Correct. Gotta work this 2,000 points out of that. We start. Now, the second version of that is Progressbar, not 4.0. Here we go. Thank you. Ooh, it's really cool. Ooh, 95 points. I'm getting good.
You've got mail.
Ooh, nice. Perfectionist mode? Nice. Check out Progressbar95 Whisper.
You've got mail.
All right. And here we have the obligatory for evaluation purpose. Okay. That's perfect. Great. Restart. Going to XP.
You've got mail.
Progressbar XP. In perfect game for XP XL.
You've got mail.
Can I get an email spam? Really? Okay. Now we all know I'm not good at Progress Bar Excel, do we? They did not show their work there because this Progress Bar is teal colored. And as we all know, none of the official Windows applications offered a teal colored progress bar, at least for Windows XP.
You've got mail.
Damn. Okay. Yeah, we know you've got a present, but trust me, that present of Clippy's not very good. Let's put up a fireball there. I like that I could have customized it too. Not looking too hot there. Okay. That was progress for XP. Up next. Progress for large horn is largely based on progress for longhorn. Did I say progress for longhorn? I meant Windows longhorn. Excuse me.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
Okay.
You've got mail.
Damn. Alright.
You've got mail.
Okay. Looks like a big drag is in order. We're done. It's pretty good. Okay. Accidentally used progress bar 7 by accident. The next one is actually progress bar Vista. For this, I believe. The second, and I think last operating system ever include the sidebar. So I like 2.5D perspective. Pretty fast, isn't it? Thank you. That was progress bar Lisa. Next is progress bar 7. Right. Progress bar 7 is the first of its kind to include the slow time feature. And I think one of the first to include that restart feature in Flippy. And there's a variation of it where you have only 15 seconds to act on your choice of whether or not to restart the system.
You've got mail.
This one. Oh, really? Video driver error here too? Wait for the problem to go away. There we go. That's, I think, twice I've encountered a video driver error.
You've got mail.
With that, we'll move on to progress bar 8. Or rather, progress bar 81. Yeah, the start menu, we'll take a look. Look at this. What was the point of having a full screen start menu? Makes no sense, does it? Right.
You've got mail.
I hate those.
You've got mail.
Right. is. Perfect score. Here we go. There are only two systems left in the Progressbar lineup. Progressbar 10, which is based off the first release of Windows 10. No mail. I'm surprised. Okay, so oh, this is the 15-second one. Go away.
You've got mail.
Perfect score. Did you start? Next up, the final release of the Progressbar lineup, Progressbar 1. This is probably the only version of Progressbar where I can suggest against playing the normal version of this game. The normal mode of this. Because look at it! Seriously, just look at it! this, man. This is the reason why I don't play this system normally. This is very frustrating. Hoping this is the end for the progress bar. Mind up. Right. CPU thing. Whoa. Sometimes the CPU thing can be helpful. Other times it'll piss you off.
You've got mail.
Removing that piece of junk. Okay. That's not a perfect progress bar, but what are you gonna do? Okay. Now it's time to restart. Up next, we'll be doing Progressbar OS. Nice design, by the way. And you even got your settings for your intro screen, which is pretty good. You thought I was done, huh? You thought I had toured all the systems of Progressbar95, but no. We got a whole new set of systems for you to enjoy. Let's start with Bar System 1. System one was the very first iteration of Progressbar. And as such, it only had normal mode. Progressbar 2 Town, which was meant to be a recreation of the very earliest version of Progressbar95. Speaking of which, hoping they release some Progressbar95 version 0.2.0 to the public as their birthday gift. Okay, I'm trying to avoid blue screening here, or black screening, or whatever color screening. Ooh, nice. Nice. Check that out. Let me show you something real cool. Progressbar 1.0 will also come with a very special file structuring system known as Filer, where in order to delete files, you had to put them into the recycle bin. Okay. In Progressbar, I mean, BarOS 1.0 was the only version that did not feature a clock that was available on the top right corner of your screen. You had to click on it. And in this version, you're getting some wasted screen space. But if you were playing this on the phone, you'd probably get able to see the clock a better fit. Okay. Looks like they've had Ben. We all know he needed his feeding. Ben in this game is sort of like a digital pet. Nice. Summer 4081. This one features the first of two difficulty sliders. Here we go, pick the ears. In progress bar, bar OS 1 introduced the cat horse. And the cat horse is sort of a reference to Apple's dog cow. Okay, in regards to Filer, still pretty much the same as it was with the Progressbar and Bar OS 1. So there's not much of a change here. BarOS System 2 introduced a new feature. The pub. Well, there we go. Puzzle finished. Starting. The next number system is for system 3. Kind of reminds you of Progress. This reminds you of Macintosh System 3. It was known for its rather irritating glitch of deleting all your saved data. And I don't mean just regular data, oh no. The catalyst looks a bit more refined in this version. Now, the first five systems were actually monochrome systems, meaning that there was no way to tell which system did what based on color, so they had to use special symbols to do everything. Regardless of whether you had the color blindness mode turned on or off, if you were playing a system that was only in black and white, this would be the only way to let you know what system, which parts did what. Regarding Filer, this will probably be the last time I show up Filer until there's a huge change in there somewhere. Because it looks pretty much the same as the normal Filer. You know, I've been around for Progress Bar ever since version 5, I believe. Back when all they had was the Progress Bar lineup of systems. Now they've got a Mac OS lineup of systems. Introduced in April 2020. This was huge. And I do mean huge in a big way. Right. Oh, the challenge is completed. Okay. Okay, real quick look at the file. No new changes, so. I almost forgot. I forgot to mention that. For OS System 3 introduced the hard, its version of the hardcore mode called High End. What High End does is cause the pieces to wobble all over the place, like in the Progressbar95, starting from level 5, I believe. But don't quote me on that. I haven't checked the progress bar wiki in a very long time. With the exception of progress bar cheat town, Bin is like a digital cut. And speaking of progress bar cheat town, that's a little something for the individual. This will be the last time you see everything in monochrome. Though there is one noticeable improvement. The minus is in grayscale. So is the bonus. That way you know the difference between the minus and the bonus scale. Oh, and one more thing that, Happy Bar says sometimes when he appears is a reference to Steve Jobs' little phrase called One More Thing, which references the last thing Steve Jobs would reveal in his keynote presentations. One last thing to get the audience really excited about what was going to happen with the new update. Computer-wise, I like PCs. Phone-wise, I like Apple. Search engine-wise, I like Google. Right. That was perfect. Oh yeah. Well, before I go to the next OS on BarOS, I should mention what you get when you go to Options and under Wallpapers. You have your own custom pattern editor. So you can draw whatever you most want as your little pattern. Of course, me being me, I can't draw anything. Let's start. Now on the Bar System 6. This is the first of the hard disks of Progressbar. Look at 5. Yeah, still the same from 1 to 5, so nothing new there. But when you go to play a game, yes, baby. This is the first version of Progressbar to feature a color display. I think about 256 colors is what this machine had, though I could be wrong. Oops. Not too bad. Oh, shit. Yeah, this is a reference to a little sad Mac icon. Thank you. go. Got that. Right there. Thankfully that... I'm pretty thankful that a crash didn't happen. Hi! No, nothing new there. So, great. Let's get the border system set. The first to have is sort of launcher. And if you check its filer, this filer has got color, baby. Yeah, but still, for the most part, it's the same filer. However, the difficulty selections in the first through six progress bars for everybody get a bit of an upgrade in the form of two mini games called Color and Jigsaw Puzzle. Which is actually pretty cool. not much different with the blue screen. Except the fact that it's in color. Seven. Let's restart. The fishing room is bar OS safe. I thought it was done a few window changes, but overall, still the same structure. Let's check data real quick. Yeah, pretty much the same stuff. Still the same stuff from 7. But still pretty cool. It wouldn't be until Bar OS 9 where we would see a big change. That, I bet you can guess what it will be. All right. Nice. Nice. Oh, new wallpaper. From Borrowers 9 side of things. A bunch of chains. Let's say Borrowers 9, I mean Borrowers 8. And I think Borrowers 8 will probably be the last time. They use the pattern as it is. Unless I'm mistaken. Now I could be mistaken, no, but believe me, I've been wrong before. And here's Borrowers 9. Where the features start rolling in. You've got a mailbox and a media player. And the second Borrowers first at the clock in the top right hand corner. But this version gives you a date too. All right. That was Borrowers 9. Ooh. Got a new wallpaper today, didn't we? And Borrowers with the digital number 9. Still has puzzle there. Still has filer. Not much else to say other than that. Now let's look at Borrowers 10. this is where the features really come into play. FireOS 10 has a login screen. Pretty cool, but check it out. Finally, we get a proper Mac version of Progress Stars. Ooh, hex code. Ooh, hex code. All right. Ooh, more hex code. Okay. Alright, let's see what the code is. Huh. Okay, so that's pretty awesome. Wow. This is what makes Terminus so cool. The file structure system. Thank you. give me a second, then, you know, I'll come to you in a minute. Where were we? Okay. That was weird. Thank you. Okay. Code breaking time. Okay. Let's see. Right there. Okay, here we go. Thank you. Let's see. Okay. Looking for something. Okay, that's enough terminus. Oof. Oof. Oh, and this. That's kind of a weird transition, but look at all that hexadecimal code in there. That's a lot of hexadecimal code, so don't panic. You're so welcome. Now that gray BSOD was a kernel pain. that was weird. And unexpected. Okay. Yeah. That's quite a lot of points. Well, one last system before I give you a little bonus.
Got mail.
So, Progressbar OS 2, yes, Terminus is still available, and yes, Terminus still has all the same features, so, but check out Filer, whoa, that's quite the overhaul, buddy, that is quite the overhaul. I actually like the wallpaper with this one. Looks pretty cool. Gotta say, we haven't seen cool things like this in a long time. Right. Awesome. Got a perfect score. That is amazing. That is amazing, my dear friend. Right. Just like I promised, I will give you the bonus operating system. There it is, folks. Progressbar 2 Town is the spiritual predecessor of Progressbar 95, its early edition. This system recreates gameplay features of the very first public version of Progressbar 95, version 0.21. It has only one game mode and a limited number of segments. There is not any utility to help you. So the gameplay is a little bit harder. That is a great way to challenge your skills. Yeah, that disclaimer read very awkwardly. But with that said, the segments are a bit smaller. Progressbar 2 Town, right? In case you haven't noticed, you're hearing the hard drive, well, the in-game one, the chug when it goes pop-up appears. This would happen even if hard drive sounds were turned off. So why would you want them turned off? The hard drive sounds are part of the experience. Well, so if you click on bin, bin here is not a digital text. It will just say empty, like in all other versions. Oh, shit. Anyway, bin here is not a digital text. It will just say empty, just like in the early versions of Progressbar, before it became empty. Perfect. Alright. That's another Progressbar 2 Town. Alright. And I bet you're wondering what the last system I usually end up on to close out the video. Well, worry no more. Because I've got the perfect one. Progressbar95 Plus.
You've got mail.
Actually does make you smile. And it's a lot of fun. Zoomed up on Progress Commander. And that'll be it for the game portion of the video.
You've got mail.
Nice! That was a perfect score!
You've got mail!
Well, that's about it. I'm going to shut down for now, and then we'll see you guys for the video portion of this video. Okay, so that's it for the game portion of this video. But what about when I did my first video on it? Well, You're about to see it pretty soon. Okay, I'm got YouTube ready. Just let me give it a while to load. Okay. Here's my YouTube. Not much about it right now, but if you go over to my page, and go to the Progressbar95 playlist. Yeah, that's the one. Let's take a look at the full playlist. All right. Okay. This was my very first Progressbar95 video.
And yes, you are looking at Progressbar95. Pretty awesome piece of history because
this is what Progressbar looked like
much as a mobile version of this
on the
G86PK,
this is what Progressbar looked like in version 5, I believe. As you can see, there's a mailbox in there.
Keyboard.
In game, you start with the PC speaker.
Okay. That way,
let's start. Let's start. Oh, you get the tutorial level.
Well, since we're playing with the keyboard and mouse, that doesn't work properly. Well, yeah, well, in your case, it would work, but the instructions are incorrect.
And here I mentioned how
alright, let's drag the progress bar here. The bulk of the throw that into that. It's hard to distinguish Charles from the program.
Keep in mind, I never, ever turned on colorblindness mode. Just so you know, it's a good idea to distinguish your colors. And Mac OS always has colorblindness mode on when it comes to the first 5 systems in the boot. Because those first 5 systems are monochrome, as I stated earlier. Now let's continue. Where's the buffering? Okay, that was pretty.
Okay.
Now keep in mind, this was also from an earlier setup where I had a webcam on the right hand side. Considering I was using in-game a CRT monitor, my webcam was able to fit there. This video was started at around 6 p.m. because that's my box again.
Alright, section. We still have a score on here. That's pretty good. The number on the left side of the fraction is the current value of the right side of the number you get, and you'll get a new value.
Okay,
so what comes to the table? Okay.
Let's take a look at the part so far. Okay. As you saw, the earlier version of Progress Bar, which I was filming with, had the pro badge on the bottom. Whereas nowadays you see the pro badge on the left.
Okay,
and as you can see, the systems are probably not in the proper order. Well, they are in the proper order technologically speaking, but not in the order you get them in the game. And if you're wondering why I didn't delete the cheat text file,
oh wait, for the trash file,
I'm thinking it's because I didn't notice it.
Whoops.
I still face a problem myself for not deleting the cheats.txt file or using defragmentation. So I do use defragmentation early. Okay, so 60%, 65%,
5%, 75%.
All right, perfect score.
Perfectionist again.
That's pretty awesome.
That's awesome.
Wow, and as you can see, considering the fact that this is the first episode of
6 megabyte frame, and the first computer upgrade and everything,
you got a first computer upgrade, that's pretty cool. 6 megs of RAM.
Alright.
Alright.
Right, let's get it. Ooh, that was good. Yeah, I need to be for the beds.
Right, the got 80.
Right.
Ooh, got the 3D screen saver mode.
Game mode.
This was right when I first got it, to tell you the truth. Nice.
We got three color files. See, let's take a look at it.
256
colors. 256 colors. Not bad. Yes, I know.
Got an 80 meg hard drive in the game, and this was my first episode. This will later be changed to accessibility. The colorblindness one would later be changed to accessibility.
And you got the cursor too, which is pretty cool. That is pretty cool. Check that progress box here. Progress box is a text-based adventure for advanced users, real hackers. By exploring directly, you can find bonuses, cheats, Easter eggs, and other secrets. Use DOS commands to explore directly. Type DOS and Messenger for a list of commands. Okay.
Take a good look at this helper. These are all the basic commands that you would find in any version of DOS. Let's continue.
Now, having an action keyboard like this can really help. So, for example, it's a pretty good directory right here. Let's see what the readme has to say. Hi, this is the game disk.
it changes each time you hit a target. Each time you both of these effects are taken in new location. Find them to left. Alright.
Rain time, you're being more safe up and ask you questions.
That's pretty random, to be honest. That's
called correctly. Made with CB to change the direction. Let's go over the block. I'm not going to touch it on the left because I have something bad.
Back then I didn't delete the unknown.exe files, but simply ignored them. Now, after having encountered a blue screen that took one of them, I actively delete them. Not sure which version of Progress Bar that was from, where I got the idea to actively delete them. But yeah. I'm going to fast forward a little bit to when we get our first upgrade in this game. Our first operating system upgrade, that is.
We will get the Matrix game mode. That's always pretty good.
Better skip ahead to that. Don't want to get any sort of copyright with that, do we?
That is pretty cool. Right.
And guess what? The bugs look like they debugged, so in a sense, you're literally finding and reporting bugs in the system. Okay.
Oh, this I can install E Device Plus right now. Good.
Well, good, a new skin for Progress 495. Wait a minute.
Check the figure out.
this time, this video is going to be the first and only time you hear Progress Bar's version of the startup and shutdown sentence.
The pro team, the expert team, the master team, the media team, which I think is pretty cool.
Anyhow, this first episode was where we got a look at Progressbar95 Plus. Okay, let's check out Progressbar95 again.
I think I need modifying to improve the window sounds, the actual window sounds of Windows 95, 98, Mini, 16, and all those. So, one thing I can mention is that we might have some different sounds.
Actually, I ended up replacing these in the next episode.
Ooh,
100
megabytes.
100 megs is a lot of megs back in the 90s.
This is awesome.
Nowadays they're doing it in
terabytes.
Definitely gonna have to skip the head to that. Seen as Progressbar 3 does use the theme song. But what Progressbar 3D is, in summary, basically you shooting down clippies and collecting bottles, and you have to use the arrow keys to move and space to shoot, or if you're using the mobile phone, the your finger to move and a tap to shoot.
Great.
Now this is scan progress, which is a special kind of minigame where you have to tap the space key really quickly, or tap the button in the mobile version of the game really quickly to scan and progress. And you get an achievement for that.
I scanned it. Okay, so
And I was only on level 7, you may ask? Okay. I'm gonna skip ahead there. This episode was the first time I started on a select system screen.
Welcome back to Progressbar95. Take a listen.
Remember when I said that I switched startup sounds in an earlier episode? That was pretty cool. Overall, this episode, like its earlier brethren, clocks in at around the 30-minute mark. I was half expecting to get like 30 minutes at most out of it. But then, little did I know that Progressbar95 would evolve into much more. This is where my first full system defrag takes place.
Defragmentation time, let's do this. There you go.
And this is the episode in which I get the pro badge with Progressbar95. Nice. And I've unlocked a special system. Progressbar 3.14. Let's check it out.
Files copied over there. Let's load it. Maybe.
Man, that was pretty cool. Nice little trip into Progressbar95's past and my past experiences with it. And this is where I get my first experience with Progressbar Minesweeper. Can you believe that I am not good at Minesweeper? No, seriously, I am not very good at Minesweeper. Well, then. With that, that has been a look into not just Progressbar95's past, but my past experiences with it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Progressbar95, and a very special happy birthday to Progressbar95. I'll see you guys in the next video. If you liked it, like, comment, and subscribe. Peace out, everyone.